How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar.
It's a statement, one of the greatest statements of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is La ilaha illallah. Al-Wahid Al-Ahad. Al-Wahid, one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Al-Ahad. Those two names together, they give you the statement of La ilaha illallah. When those two names come, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one, and there is no second with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is no similarity, there is no match. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There is nothing example like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The name of Allah, Al-Wahid, Al-Wahid, أي لا شريك له. Has no partner, no companion and no partner, that is Al-Wahid. Al-Ahad, لا مثيل له. لا مثيل له, nothing is like him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with two names together will reach you and take you to the real fact and the fact of the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal of La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, and that is the great favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. That statement, the statement will save us from the hellfire, and that statement will take us completely to the Jannah inshaAllah, and that statement will give us strength and power in the grave, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala establish those who believe with the strength and power with the word of La ilaha illallah in this dunya and in the akhirah inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. And we are here speaking to two types or two kind of people. People, غير المؤمن بالتوحيد, people who does not believe in the tawheed, the monotheism of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or people who have doubt, shak, and those people, they are under the control of the shaytan wal-iyadu billah. And also, we speak about the kind of believers, Muslimin believers, and those believers, they say, La ilaha illallah, but they don't feel the sensitivity or the sweetness of La ilaha illallah. They say it by words, they say it by tongue, and there is no feeling for that. So, now, كيف تتحول? How is the word of La ilaha illallah? It transform in my body, or it change my life. And, not only by the tongue, but is a fact or a taking a place in my life, and I live with it. I live with it, I live also for it, the word of La ilaha illallah. How I make every single particle or space in my body says La ilaha illallah. How I make all my body called of La ilaha illallah. Even when speaking to intellectual things and the brain, the mind, كلمة الأحد, by the way, the word الأحد is passed in the Quran only one. And Al-Wahid, it comes 15 times in the Quran. So Al-Ahad, meaning again, La makila lah. There is nothing like him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was the Qul huwa Allahu Ahad. Qul huwa Allahu Ahad. That is the third of the Quran. This surah was the surah when the one of the Sahaba رضوان الله تعالى عليهم, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, because you love this surah, you're going to be in the Jannah. Now, Al-Wahid, أي لا شريك له. They have no partner, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we said 15 times in the Quran. So how we live with the name of Allah, Al-Wahid, and the name of Allah, Al-Wahid, Al-Ahad, and how we have this in our conscious, in our brain, in our mind. How we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the mind, or the brain, or the conscious. I want you to think for a moment. What is the meaning of Al-Wahid, Al-Ahad? Just when we speak about that, we speak about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create everything from one source, the earth, the sun, the galaxy, us, we came from male female. The male fertilized the female, and we came from one drop. And the female also one egg. Not only that, so with the human being or the animals or even the plants or even the fish in the first stages. On the first stages, it's similar, exactly. There is nothing different. Just like one drop from them to the woman and the baby comes out. The animals is the same thing. One drop from the rain all the way to the ground, that seed will grow up and make give us a plantation or a vegetation or a fruit or things to eat. Let's read together some of the ayat from Surah At-Tariq. Some of the ayat from ayah number 5. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فلينظر الإنسان مما خلق. فلينظر الإنسان, let man only think from what he is created, from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create mankind. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خلق من ماء دافق. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created from a drop. Image drop, one drop, من ماء دافق. يخرج من بين الصلب والترائب. And that comes from in the bone, in the middle of the bone of a human being, in the ribs of the human being, of the man. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهُ عَلَىٰ رَجْعِهِ لَقَادِرٍ. Surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to bring him back from life. Because Allah created us from nothing. He can bring us from nothing also. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ تُبْلَى السَّرَائِرِ. Then the day that all things secret will be tested. Everybody will come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we are speaking about that kind of water that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ مِمَّا خُلِقْ خُلِقَ مِنْ مَاء. مَاء, water, the word in Arabic language, مَاء is a water. And that actually, the water actually contained with that is just 90% of the serum, 90%. Imagine that is just like regular water. And the rest of it is just 1 to 5%, those the sperm. And then not only that, and the rest is the chemical composition, like phosphate, potassium, glucose, fructose, magnesium, zinc, all those minerals. But subhanAllah Rabbil Alameen, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that, فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانِ, this is a sign for me to believe in الْوَاحِدِ الْأَحَدِ. فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانِ مِمَّ خُلِقْ. And that was only one. To the egg, touching the egg, then we come from that. Imagine that, from one. Then, of course, all the biologists, they say, the human being and also the animals, for the embryo, for the initial stage, come from one system, one only. And now, if Allah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created a human being. If there is two gods, wal-iyadu billah, of course, they will have different. If I have two eyes, if there is two gods, they will say they have three eyes, or four eyes, or even one eye. They will be always in doubt, and always in fight. But only Al-Wahid Al-Ahad, the one he created me in the beautiful picture, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانِ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمِ. In the beautiful, the most beautiful picture that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created mankind in human being. And let's read some ayat from Surah Al-Mu'minun, beautiful surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينٍ. We created man from clay. And this is some certain clay, not any clay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. Then, ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then we placed him like a drop of semen firmly fixed in a place of rest inside the womb or inside the female. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة. Then Allah عز وجل says, then we made the semen into a mass of half blood. It's just like blood. علقة is blood. فخلقنا العلقة مضغة. Then from that mass, we made the early embryonic baby like womb. It's not a baby, complete baby. فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَطَ عِظَامًا. That lump become like a bone, small bone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَخَلَقْنَا فَكَسَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ لَحَنْ. Those bone we cover it with a flesh. ثم after that, there is the difference between human beings and animals and fish and the others. ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then we devolve that creation to another creation. Creatures, different creatures. Human being, the human being. Monkey, the monkey. Is a animal, is an animal, and so on and so on. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and think about this, the end of the ayah. تتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين. So, please, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best of the creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أحسن الخالقين, the best one creating. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at the human being. Just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وفي أنفسكم, in you. أفلا تبصرون, don't you see? Don't you see? I want you to think about those ayat from Surah Al-Mu'minun. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create us from one drop to one drop, two drops together, then create a complete human being. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Rum, I'm not going to go through that in detail, but look at Al-Wahid Al-Ahad. Then after we born from da'af, weakness. The baby, they have no hawl, no qawwa, no nothing. No qawwa, no strength, the baby. And ثم بعد الضعف قوة. After this, we grow up, they grow up, we become very strong. And after, then after this strong of power, ضعف وشيبة. Not only that, we become very old. يخلق ما يشاء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates whatever he wants. The way he wants subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no challenge. No one can create that. This is, so that is al-wahid, al-ahad. And nothing will come like something like this. Yes, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create Adam, but create Adam from the sand, but still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, kun fayakun. Only Allah will be it, and that's it. Subhanallah. And all the ayat in the Quran, so beautiful, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing those nature for the intellect. We're talking about intellectual here, for the brain, for the thing, for the people, they think they are smart and intelligent. With this subh, was subh, idha tanafas, tanafas in Arabic language, the breathing, how the morning comes with the different breeze, different way. And this is walayli, another idha as. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create a special enzyme in the body, comes immediately after sunset. When there is a sunset, there is an enzyme in the body, give the person some kind of relaxation. And then the night comes step by step. Create as in Arabic language, that means easy. You don't even feel it, suddenly is the night. It's not boom one time. No, it is step by step by the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look, everything takes steps too, like the baby. 9 months is staying in the womb of the mother after born. This earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in 6 days. And the geologist, they say 6 age, like 60 stages. Every stage takes like 550,000 years. So subhanallah. So that only in the hand of al-wahid, al-ahad, إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. My dear brothers and sisters, we're speaking about the cosmic, the universe, the galaxy. For the intellectual, if there is two gods, they will make the sun go different way, or instead the sun rises from the east will be rising from the west. They will fight. But because only one, only Allah, the one subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why he created and he designed it and fashioned it in the way he wants subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at this, and not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us so special. And the way it's special, everything in this universe or atmosphere works for us. Works for me as a human being. Allah, everything created, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything created on earth is for me as a human being. Blessing, ni'mah, favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, well, look at this, Ibrahim alayhi salam, with this kind of argument with Namrud ibn Kan'ar ibn Kush, and say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ أَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ. Say, the one he argue with the king, and the king Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, I am God, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. Say, إِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّي الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ. My Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this, and يُحْيِي, make life, and make this. قال أنا أحيي وأميت. His intellectual, his understanding, he said, I make this and make life for the people, because he thinks he can provide risk to the people. He can make the people in the prison, he can kill anybody he wants, he can release anybody he wants. That's what he thinks. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, he used this kind of intellectual thinking, and he said, فإن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق تأتي بها من الله bring the sun from the east bring it from the west bring it from the west and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says فبهت الذي كفر بهت that means his face completely changed the color of his face changed his life changed فبهت الذي كفر والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين Allah is not going to guide those people they have no guidance those people والعياذ بالله So my dear brothers and sisters, everything in this universe integrates for a human being. In the way it's so unique, you cannot even imagine it. If you come to this sun, the beautiful sun, and that's with the energy of the sun. The energy, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends this energy and this heat to the surface of the water, and the water evaporates, and those evaporation small particles of water attached to each other and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the wind and the wind spreads to different places those clouds we call it the clouds to different place and when this cloud becomes so heavy it will drop in a certain area all who can control this only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala no one can create that it's a, so I can create evaporation you know what you cannot create a cloud you cannot create a rain you cannot send the oxygen You need oxygen. And when you release, you send what? Carbon dioxide. The plant or the tree is different. They take the carbon dioxide and they send oxygen. Look at this kind of integration and link. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it. If there is no plant, there is no trees, there is no oxygen. They send us oxygen, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this, all this works for me, for you, for all of us as a human being. With this bee. The bees flying go to the flower and take the juice of the flower and at the same time the legs and the hand of the bee take the pollen and take those seeds from different place different flowers to different and then will that flower or that bees release those small very tiny seeds and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create more flowers and more trees and so on and so on So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that which he, taking the juice of the flower, give me honey. And not only that, it helps actually is more cultivation, more cultivation and more flowers and more trees and so on and so on. And then only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this kind of integration for me. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-Nam qal, أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ Say, is there another God besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There is no God but Allah. There is no God can control this universe but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Wahid, Al-Ahad, only La ilaha illallah. And when we feel this, my dear brothers and sisters, we have this special feeling in the heart. And this kind of special feeling, there is no one will feel it unless you feel the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, Bilal, just remind me with Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When they found out he's a Muslim, And they make him in Ramadan Mecca, the desert of Mecca. And they tied him up. And they stabbed him and put a huge rock on the top of Bilal radiallahu ta'ala. And what Bilal said? The only statement he used to say, Ahadun Ahad. Ahadun Ahad. Ahadun Ahad. That's what he used to say. And they asked him after that, why you always this one? Because he said, that's the only name of Allah I know make them angry. This pain is gone. Why? Because his relationship with Al-Wahid Al-Ahad very strong. He understands of Ilaha Illallah or the meaning of La Ilaha Illallah. Mashita bint Fir'aun, the hairdresser of the daughter of the Pharaoh. And you know the story very well. When she dropped the comb and she went to pick up the comb, she said, Bismillah. The daughter, she said, Bismillah, do you mean Allah is my father? Qalat La. No, my Lord and your Lord and your father Lord, Allah, Rabbil Alameen. Strong belief, she know the circumstances. She know what's going to happen to her. She know that very well that the Pharaoh will kill her. He brought the daughter, she immediately report her father and he brought her with four kids. Four kids. And you know in the story, in the hadith, have a pot of boiling water. And he said, do you believe in me as a God? No, my Lord and your Lord, Allah, Rabbil Alameen. And he take the first son And the son screamed and screamed and her heart moving. But the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established in the heart more strongly. And the second son and the third son, and now a baby between her arms. They take the baby and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the baby speak. Say, do not hesitate, mom. The Jannah is waiting for us. And after that, the Pharaoh himself, he put that woman inside the fire, subhanallah rabbil alamin, that boiling water, the love of Allah. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was on the Mi'raj, and he smelled a beautiful smell, and he said, ya Jibreel, what is this smell? And Jibreel alayhi salam, he told him, the smell of the Mashitat binti Fir'aun, the hairdresser of the daughter of the Fir'aun, and her kids. Yes, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we know that in the story, when the father of Ammar, Yasir, and Sumayya, and they mentioned La ilaha illallah. Say, اذكروا آلهتنا بخير. Mention اللات والعزة in a good way. There is no way. Why? The heart filled with love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, when we know this kind of love, the whole dunya will be very small in front of our eyes. That's why we must know the conditions of La ilaha illallah. We must know, we have to know the conditions of La ilaha illallah. Not only a statement you say it by the tongue. It's not only that. If you don't know those conditions, that means you are not going to have a normal life. You just say it, but you don't believe it yet. Until you know 7 conditions of La ilaha illallah. 7 of those conditions, if you know it, then you will have this kind of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one of those conditions, al-ilm. Al-ilm, the knowledge of la ilaha illallah. La ilaha, there is no God. Illallah, but Allah to be worshipped subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you don't know the meaning of la ilaha illallah, then just like you speak language or you hear language and you don't understand it. Just like a gibberish language, something you cannot understand. This, if you just say it without understanding, that means you're not feeling of la ilaha illallah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Muhammad, فَعَلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. You have to know, Muhammad, there is no God to be worshipped, deserved to be worshipped, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And listen to this ayah, my brothers and sisters. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Only says those who truly fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those who have a knowledge that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the supreme power. Only Allah azza wa jal. Only the people, they know Allah, the people, they have the knowledge, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. That's why we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means we have to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you are afraid of something, you run away from that thing. But if you are afraid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you run to Allah. You go to Allah. You ask Allah azza wa jal. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال, من مه, whoever died, وهو أعلم, and he knows, أنه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. See, whoever died, and he knows there is no God to be worshipped but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that person of the Jannah. الحسن البصري رحمه الله, الحسن البصري, they ask him, قال أبا الحسن رضي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, whoever say لا إله إلا الله will enter the Jannah. قال نعم, he will enter the Jannah, ولكن من أدى حقها وفرضها. The right of لا إله إلا الله, the obligations of لا إله إلا الله is not only a statement, we have to feel it, we have to understand it. That's why the condition number two of those conditions of لا إله إلا الله, اليقين. اليقين, certainty, assurance. That when I say la ilaha illallah, I have to believe it in the heart, established inside my heart without doubt. Without doubt. That's why we say ashadu in Arabic language, ashadu, from I see. Not only witness, no, I see. Ashadu an la ilaha illallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and listen to this hadith, qala, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله لا يلقى الله لا يلقى الله بلا عبد غير شاك فيهما إلا أدخله الله الجنة. صحيح مسلم. سيد الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the statement of لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, whoever says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that statement and there is no doubt in his heart, there is no doubt, suspicion in his heart about this statement, and with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enter in the Jannah. Why? Because if you know it, you will work with it. So number two we said is al-yaqeen, or certainly, or assurance. But with that statement, yaqeen in the heart, established in the heart, sitting in the heart of mankind, for human being to become a real Muslim, my dear brothers and sisters. Number three, al-qubul, acceptance. You have to accept la ilaha illallah. Meaning, everything of la ilaha illallah required by the tongue or by the heart, I have to believe it. I have to believe it. With no interpretation, you can interpret things, so explain things is not that Allah Azza wa Jalla told us to do it. Listen to this ayah, all of us we recited in the end of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم believe what Allah Azza wa Jalla has revealed to him and the believers. كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله. We believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his angels and his books and his messengers. لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله. I have no differentiation between his messengers. وقالوا here, listen carefully. سمعنا وأطعنا. That is the key. سمعنا, we hear. You have the acceptance. We speak about acceptance here. We hear and we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ. So that is the key. When you say al-qubul, the opposite of qubul or acceptance is return or reject. That's why you have to accept everything. So there is some people, they know. They know the meaning of la ilaha illallah. They know the meaning of la ilaha illallah, but they reject it. They refuse to follow la ilaha illallah. Why? For two things, my dear brothers and sisters. Number one, al-kibr. They reject the acceptance. They know it, but they reject it because they have kind of pride, arrogance. This son of arrogant Iblis. He used to be in the Jannah with Adam alayhi salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order Iblis and the angels to make sujood to Adam, prostration to Adam alayhi salam, he refused. How come? He said, you create him from fire and create Adam from sand? Why? How come I make sujood for this? But us as a believer, we say we hear and we obey. That's why the angels sajadu, make sujood. All the angels, they make sujood to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, and that is also important, al-hasad, envy. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, حَسَدًا مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِهِمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الْحَقِّ. Ayah number 109 Surah Al-Baqarah, they would wish to turn you back from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Out of selfishness, envy. Even if they know the truth, they know the truth is true, but they still envy you. Still, they don't want you to become a Muslim. They don't want you to become a believer. They want you to turn you back. So two things. The people, they have this kind of pride in their hearts, arrogant. We don't want to follow this. How come? And you know what? Many people in this century, they follow their desires, their hawa, and that's really scary, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. That's why there's a lot of those people, they are not Muslim. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, إنهم كانوا إذا قيل لهم لا إله إلا الله يستكبرون. When they tell them لا إله إلا الله, they become so arrogant, selfishness. They don't want to say لا إله إلا الله. That's why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gathered the people of Quraysh, all the tribes, and he stood up in the Safa. قال قولوها تسود بها العرب والعجم. Say the statement. You will be the leaders for Arab and non-Arab. Say لا إله إلا الله. They understand, that's why they reject la ilaha illallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that. And we come to the acceptance here, number three, the acceptance. The opposite of acceptance, you reject. Even if you reject one of the rules and regulations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even one. Number four, al-inqiyad, obedience and absolute submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obedience and complete or absolute submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that ittiba' bil af'al wa laysa bil qawl faqat. By the action, not by only statement. By the action, by not the statement only. Al-qubul, the one before, just that is approve this one. You know, that one, you say it, and then this one you accept it. And you submit yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning absolute submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, A'udhu billahi minash rajim, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. Say, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now, and submit your face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, that's why not only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave you, you take it. And whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reject you leave it and you go away. That is prohibit al-halalu bayin wal-haramu bayin. That's why you have to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Completely listen to this ayah, Marie Bursan Surah Al-Nisa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear, قَلَ فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Say, by your Lord, they cannot have no faith, no iman, unless they make you a judge in all their matters. All their matters, oh Muhammad, you are the judge, you are the final one here. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا. Not only acceptance, we talk about inqiyad, and acceptance, and feeling peace and tranquility, and whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave you. ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتْ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. You have a complete submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we understand of la ilaha illallah, then we'll go to this one, number four, the inqiyad. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's uncle, Abu Talib, he know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying the truth. He know la ilaha illallah. He know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought the Islam, and still the last moment in his life, he refused to say la ilaha illallah. He know it, but he refused to say it. That's why it will take us to the fifth, number five. As-sidq. As-sidq against the word kadhib, lies. Faithfulness, honesty, sincerity, that as-sidq. Sidq al-iman wa sidq al-aqidah. So be true in iman, in belief, and true in your belief completely, for whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to believe in this. And you have to work as all your ability, all your power, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To know what is right, and to know what is wrong, and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you to the right. أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع صادقين. Say, oh, you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be with those who are in true path. Sadiqeen, the truthful people, be among them. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, من قال لا إله إلا الله, whoever say لا إله إلا الله, listen, صادقا من قلبه, صادقا, truthful from his heart, دخل الجنة. Look at the condition. The condition is لا إله إلا الله from the heart, not from the tongue. That will enter the Jannah. That will the Jannah be guaranteed. So because if we are not truthful, that means the opposite of truth is nifaq, hypocrisy. May Allah protect us from the hypocrisy. Ameen. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Some of the people, may Allah protect us from that, they say, we believe in Allah, and we believe in the last day. وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. They are not believers. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهِ. They make a bit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they actually, in fact, in reality, they betrayed themselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that. After number five, the sixth, take us to one of the important branch of those conditions of la ilaha illallah, al-ikhlas, sincerity and loyalty only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is this kind of sincerity or ikhlas? The mean purified all purify my deeds and my a'mal from any crime of deficiency only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything I do in life supposed to be only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I do it, there is no hypocrisy, no showing off, there is no because my reputation or my name or my service benefits or service purpose or so on. No, it's only for Subhanahu wa Taala. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal says, "A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim." وَمَا أُنِيرُ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Say they have an order commanded only to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity and devotion, and only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, أسعد الناس بشفاعتي يوم القيامة. The most happy people with my intercession or my shafa'a in the day of judgment, من قال لا إله إلا الله. Whoever say لا إله إلا الله خالصا من قلبي. Sincerity is completely pure from the heart, not from the tongue, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. With this also, we say ikhlas, sincerity, also to follow the steps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we say the Prophet says so and so, that's what we should follow, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. With questions asked, that take us to al-mahabba, the number 7, love the statement of la ilaha illallah, and always this is joined, integrate with the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the vocation and the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that take us with the fear and hope. Khawf wa raja'. Between khawf, afraid from Allah, the punishment of Allah, but I still have hope, and that hope is the Jannah, the paradise, al-firdaus al-a'la with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, and we dislike what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلْدُوسِ believers, they love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. Absolutely love only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If this the core of your heart become Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la ilaha illallah, al-wahid al-ahad, you'll feel all your body calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're feeling every single particle in your body, in your calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Misra subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this statement, my dear brothers and my sisters, we have love and tranquility and peace in the heart. That's why we have to understand, say la ilaha illallah, say la ma'bud. There is no one should be worshipped or deserve to be worshipped but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-wahid, al-ahad, la sharika lah, la mathila lah. There is no partner, there is no similarity like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only one deserves to be worshipped, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of benefits of this, my dear brothers and sisters. I want to share with you, when the time is running very fast, I want to share with you hadith. حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن عبد الله بن عمر بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله تعالى عنه قال يصاح برجل من امتي على رؤوس الخلائق يوم القيامه. One person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call that person in every seed that فينشر له 99 سجلا. Is the 99 scroll or a records for that person. Every record extend or stretch out all the way to the horizon. 99. Imagine. ثم يقال الله سبحانه وتعالى, do you deny all these records? And then he will say, لا يا رب. No, my Lord. قال ألك عذر. Do you have any excuse? قال لا يا رب. قال أو حسنة. Maybe one حسنة. Only one حسنة. قال لا يا رب. And he becomes so afraid. He said, I am vanished. I am destroyed. That's it. I am done. فَيُقَالُوا بَلَى إِنَّ لَكَ عِنْدَنَا حَسَنَاتٍ. There is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, there is حَسَنَات. Good deeds. وَإِنَّهُ لَا ظُلْمَ عَلَيْكَ. There is no unjust or unfair with you today. فَيُخْرَجْ لَهُ بِطَاقَةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring him a card. Card, small card. Like a business card. فَيُخْرَجْ لَهُ بِطَاقَةٍ. فِيهَا written there, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. That small card written, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. فيقول يا رب ما هذه البطاقة, ما هذه, with this folder, what is this card, with those records, scrolls, books, all the way extend out all the way to the horizon, what is this? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until order the angel فيقال انك لا تظلم. There is no unjust or unfair here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or that small card will put it in the scale, and all his 99 scroll are record in one scale. فطاشت السجلات وثقلت البطاقة. Those records, the 99 of these, all over the place, all over the place, and that small card be heavy in the scale. That's why I call it كلمة الإخلاص, the sincerity, the statement of sincerity. Whoever say that statement is the price of the Jannah. That make you, when you say it, you have maghfirah, forgiveness and mercy, and your erased would be your sins would be erased, and your iman in the heart renewing all the time. And not only that statement been traced all the way to the heaven, to another heaven, until reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that statement, the best statement all the Prophet has mentioned of La ilaha illallah, that statement, the best of dhikr and remembering of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that statement is the best of the a'mal, the deeds of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that statement is a protection from the shaitan, that statement will be with me inside my grave, that statement with me with my in the day of the resurrection, that statement is the slogans of the believers, that statement the slogans of people of the Jannah. When you say that statement,
how can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar.